Mark Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2429, minute-by-minute stock price arrows. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Question on one of my YouTube videos here from Broadway Gypsy. Great. Is there a possibility to create a minute-to-minute changing up-down stock arrow? Wow, that's intriguing. I bet it is. But, you know, this question actually brings up a lot more questions. Like, do you already have the stock data or do we need to get it? Do you want just one arrow or the whole day of arrows? Or just the last five arrows? Is the most recent data at the top or the bottom? Are you using Windows, Mac, Excel Online, or something else? Do you have Microsoft 365? Because that would let us use data types. All right, so let's start easy. Assume that you already have the data. And then later, I'll show you how to go get the data provided you have Microsoft 365. So what I have here today is a Microsoft stock price starting just after the market opened until about 2 or 3 minutes ago. And to get the change, of course, we take the most recent price minus the previous price. And the problem with that is that we're going to be getting a whole bunch of different size numbers. I just want to know, are we up, are we down? So the awesome way to change that is to use the SIGN, the sign function. It only returns three possible values. If it's positive, you get a one. If it's negative, you get a negative one. And if it's zero, you get a zero, right? So only three possible answers now in that column. And then to get the arrows, conditional formatting, icon sets. And you could use this one, I suppose, with the up, right, and down arrow. I like this one with the up triangle. They call it three triangles. It's not three triangles at all. Hey, Microsoft, it's two triangles and a rectangle. But I'm going to get rid of that thing in the middle anyway. So we'll go with this one. Right, and what we get is a little arrow indicating whether we're down or up. Now I'm going to customize this. Conditional formatting, manage rules, edit rule, and then here, see it's based on 67% and 33%. I'm going to change both of those to an absolute number. And there's only three possible numbers I want to get. I'm going to get a 1, 0, or negative 1. So if we are greater than 0, that's the 1, we'll use the green triangle. No cell icon here if we're greater than or equal to 0. That can only be zeros. And then everything else is negative one. And I don't want to show the minus ones and ones. I just want to show the arrow. So here, show icon only. We'll choose that. Click OK. Click OK. And now we have a series of arrows showing up and down. Scroll down through. What does the blank mean? That means that in that minute, there was no change. At least, you know, at the time that I pulled it. So the most recent change is down. Now this makes me think of all kinds of things. Like, shouldn't we be showing whether we're up or down for the whole day? Well, you know, hey, this is open source. Download the workbook. Feel free to change it yourself. So this assumes you already have the data. But let's assume you don't have the data. All right. Now this requires Microsoft 365 because I'm going to use an awesome thing here called data types. So I'll type a stock symbol, Microsoft data, and declare that as stocks. Goes out to the internet, figures out what I'm trying to talk about here. I want the one on the NASDAQ market. It's so funny, they didn't ask that earlier today when I set this up. And then over here in B1, I'm going to say equal A1.price. Now you should click through to this and see what the delay is. I believe the delay is about 5 minutes now. It depends on your local stock exchange though, so always check so you know what you're dealing with there. And then what I need is a way that every minute I will grab new data and save it. Now, there's an awesome thing that changed recently here under data type refresh settings, where they will now let me say that stocks should be refreshed automatically every 5 minutes. It used to be it was only when I went into data refresh all, but now you can set it for every 5 minutes. And had the question been, can you give me an arrow every 5 minutes? Well, I'd kind of be home free, but you didn't ask that. You wanted, can we update every minute? So that forces me over to VBA, which means that this isn't going to work on Excel Online. And it may not work on a Mac. If you have a Mac, your experience may vary. I don't have a Mac. I can't test the code. But let's switch over here. All right, so here was the little sheet that I created this morning about 9 o'clock, and I started it to run at 9:33. And what it does is every minute, it grabs the current price here. It does a refresh. Gets the current time and the current price. So like right there, it just updated. Did you see it? 284.65. And if I scroll down here, we see that at this last minute at 1359, 284.65. And if I kept talking for a minute, you would see that it would update again. All right, now, what is this? In cell A1, I converted MSFT to a data type, and then it looks like here in B2, I have equal A1.price. So I know that A1 and B2 are important. Originally, I had the now function there, but I actually have that updating with VBA. You'll notice that this is saved as an XLSM, and please don't skip this step. If you've never used macros before, your file is currently in XLSX. In XLSX, the default Excel file type will delete your macro. So all of the work that you do from here on out will be lost, right? So file, save as, change the file type to XLSM. If you don't have the developer tab, right click, customize the ribbon, and then choose developer. Once you have the developer tab, go into macro security and move it down to the second option. If it's already at the top, move it down to the second option. I'm not going to recommend that you go to 3 or 4. If you're already there, then someone different than me suggested that, and you can just leave it where it is. But it has to be at least at the second one. All right, and then what we're going to do is we're going to say, oh, there, see, it just updated again. We're going to say that we're going to have a little macro. That macro is going to copy the current price to the next row. It's going to copy the current date and time to the next row. And then it's going to build this formula out here, the sine of B6 minus B5. All right, so let's go take a look at that code. Tiny, tiny little bit of code. I wasn't sure if I'd be switching to other Excel workbooks throughout the day. This is actually running in its own instance of Excel. By the way, hot tip, if you need Excel to open in its own instance, hold the Alt key. Just keep holding it. Right click on Excel down in your taskbar and keep holding the Alt key while you open a new instance. It'll say, are you trying to open a new instance of Excel? And you say, yes, yes, I am. All right, so we're gonna define the worksheet as this workbook.worksheets1 because it's the first worksheet. And then here, this awesome little bit of code, .refreshed linked data type. WSCells11, that's row 1, column 1, that's cell A1, that's where I have that MSFT data type. Do events lets that finish, right? Because it takes a little bit of time to run out to the internet and get it. And then here in cell row 2, column 1, that's A2, the value is now. Now is just like the now function in Excel, except it's not a formula, it just timestamps what time it is. And then I go and figure out what the next row is. Now, hey, for anyone who's never done macros before, I guarantee that you're gonna get this wrong. That's an XL. Everyone thinks it's a 1, and I agree that the font makes it look like a 1. It's an L, XL up dot row. So we go down to the last row in the worksheet, press the N key, press the up arrow key, or control up arrow, see what row we're on, and we know that we wanna go one row below that. All right, and then I write to column 1 of that row, the value from row 2, column 1, and the value from row 2, column 2. So that's the date and the current stock price. And then in column 3, I built a little formula here. This is an R1C1 reference. I'm not going to take the time to explain that today. It's just beautiful that it says we're taking the value of this row and the row 1 above us. And then, because I'm about to have this thing just start to run itself, right? And, you know, I'm always afraid. You always hear about robots that take over the world, right? I hate when Excel starts to run itself because when I try and close Excel, it reopens itself, right? So just because I've been burned by that so many times, and I realize how ridiculous that sounds, I just like to have some control. So out here in cell, that's I, row 1, column I. If I write the value true there, then it's going to stop. It's going to stop running automatically. Otherwise, application.onTime, now plus 1 minute from now, I'll run this macro again called save price, right? And then from here, I did Alt F8, chose save price, and had it start to run. And so you see that every minute, it automatically updates until I type true, right? So once we get past the end of market day, market closes at 4. In this case, I'm gonna change that to true and let it go one more minute. So that way on that last update, it won't kick off the instructions to run again. I've closed Excel and had it just reopen and start to run the macro again, right? So just have a little bit of control there. You know, now some hassles here is that this data is gonna be growing throughout the day, although we can predict it's a 6.5 hour market. So what is that, 210 rows? I should go through in column C and format everything with arrows before we begin. If you wanted things to appear at the top instead of the bottom, well, you know, you have to push cells down. I mean, there's plenty of ways to deal with whatever all those unanswered questions that Broadway Gypsy did not answer. But this kind of gives you the starting point. If you have questions, if you can't figure it out, down below in the YouTube comments, let me know. Well, hey, there's a couple of different books here. Mr. Excel 2021, Unmasking Excel, deals with how to use the data types. But to be able to automate and run every minute, that's the Excel VBA and macros. There's a 2019 edition now. There's actually an edition of this going all the way back to 2003, 2007, 2010, 2013, 2016, 2019, and soon a new one for Microsoft 365, right? So that will get you up the learning curve on VBA, or, you know, you can just watch YouTube. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the YouTube comments below. Well, hey, I want to thank Broadway Gypsy for leaving that great question on my YouTube channel. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.